Welcome back to Africa Express. We were discussing the relationship between Christians and Muslims in the country of Sierra Leone. Pastor, in time where there is ethnic cleansing in other countries and there's rift between Muslims and Christians in other countries, how come Sierra Leone is different? The relationship between the Muslims and Christians seem to be different in Sierra Leone.
I think the most important thing that we practice in Sierra Leone is respect and love. Because in every situation, you know, when you respect somebody, that means you esteem somebody. And the Bible says that we have to love our neighbors. And God did not specify who our neighbors are. But our neighbors are humans who God created. It doesn't say love the Christians. It doesn't say love the Muslim or other. It said love your neighbors. And so therefore, if we respect humanity, then whoever is our neighbor, we have to love. Because the Bible says God is love, and whoever loves is born of God. And so for us as Christians, we love the Muslims because they are created by God. It doesn't bother us that they are Muslims, but God created them, and they are worshiping a supreme being. It's only that the way we worship is quite different. And so that's where we build our relationship with one another because we respect them and we love them. We are not controversial to their beliefs. We respect what they do. And so that's why we don't have no problem in Sierra Leone.
So you're saying that tradition has not impacted the saying in the Bible that says love your neighbor, because they've not incorporated their tradition, because tradition could be quite different depending on what tribe you're talking about, you know, but they've set that aside, you're saying, to love one another, to actually practice what is in the Bible, love one another.
Love one another, that's right, because God gave 10 commandments, and he brought those commandments into two. Bible says, love God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your spirit. And love your neighbor as yourself. And so when we try to put our cultural tradition and religion, there where the problem comes. And when you see today in some parts of the world, people are fighting and doing other things because they deviated from what the Word of God says. Because the Word of God says love. And love does not discriminate anyone. Because God created us, not everybody that is worshiping him. But when the rain comes, it falls on the people who say there is no God. It falls everywhere. And so if we are real believers, and so tradition shouldn't complicate or implicate us in loving one another. But we have to apply the tradition of the Bible that God said, love your neighbor as yourself. But the moment we brought in our cultural or traditional beliefs, then that's where we deviate from worshiping God. And that's why you see into the other countries are having problem because they deviated from the Word of God and they brought in their own tradition. And when you believe on tradition, you want to protect your tradition. You want to esteem yourself as you are the best. And so in God, all of us are equal. And so that's why I'm coming again, that in Sierra Leone, we respect one another, we love one another, and we are there for one another.
Alhaji Mustafa, in West Africa, lots of countries, we have ethnic cleansing, either by Muslims or by Christians. Do you believe that it is culture or that they have incorporated traditional belief, that is why what causes the rift between them, or that is what actually that stems the problems and not the word of the Bible and the Quran?
Yes, in many other countries, like the pastor said, in Sierra Leone is very unique. We are protected by unity, by our beliefs in humanity. But when you visit other countries where there is atrocity in between the Christians and the Muslim is because of three things. The economy, politics is the most ruling agent in the religion. like they said, don't mix politics and religion. People want to terrorize certain areas, or people want to enforce their religion, their beliefs, like the Sunna belief, on people. We find that in a certain part of Africa. Because I do not believe in your aspects, therefore you should accept mine. They are forcing people to accept their own belief. That is creating a problem. The culture is telling us one thing. Politics is telling us one thing. The desire for the wealth, we call it in my language, dunyanemi. Dunyanemi is the wealth of the world. I'll forget the relationship between me and my brother. I would like to have it all. I would have him to look up to me, not to the Lord. And that kind of atrocity in certain areas, we call it civilization in certain area, is killing. It's really killing the religion, both religions in certain area. It's disuniting them.
We will take a break and come back and continue the discussion.